how to make your hair move. And yes, an actual tutorial, finally. Quick notice. I use After Effects CS6. I'm not an expert in After Effects. I'm bad at explaining things. My grammar sucks. Thank you. 1. Separate the hair part. You can do it like this. As for a big part, yeah, separate it too. Because if you don't, it may look awkward. You can use any software or application you have, as long as it's transparent PNG. I suggest you to rename the layer. You can do it in Photoshop or in After Effects. To open After Effects, composition, new composition, name your composition, keep everything the same. Oh wait, you can change the frame rate, duration, and background color if you want, but I usually go with this. Open file, import your PNG file, and yes, that's my file name. If you use Photoshop, change the import kind to composition and choose the second option. Click and drag the image composition over here. Double click if you wanna see the layers. This is an awful example. If you don't use Photoshop, import your body parts, drag them. My god. Then you can arrange them. Spoiler alert. It is frustrating. Quick introduction. This is your preview. Basically where you drag everything around. This is your imported file list. This is where you work with time, layers, effects list, alignment. I don't care about this one. Your tool. I recommend to use shortcut so you can work faster. Press Ctrl Z for undo. Command Z if you use Mac. Ctrl S, Ctrl S, Ctrl S, press Ctrl S to every move you made. 3. Press one of the hair layer. Pen tool. Unnecessary, but I usually press anywhere before actually pin the hair part. Inside the yellow part is where you can put your pin. Click on very top, middle, and the end of your hair part. My god. Move it with selection tool, just to make sure it doesn't look weird. You can always undo and fix it if it does look weird. Once you're done, open mesh 1, deform. Open all of these. We don't really need puppet pin 1. So press the keyframe and backspace, or just press this icon and it will remove every keyframe on its row. You may close it and do this to the rest of the hair. I'll wait. So I actually slept for 6 hours after type that sentence. Have you done yet? Now we will make the basic wind blow. It's just the hair animation in Gacha Club. But jello. Open the layer you want. You can move it if you want. Move this. I never know how to call stuff. It's like remembering everything about your friend except their name. So bear with me. The further you go, the longer the movement will be. Just saying. And then move the puppet pin to the pose you want. I go left. By the way, it will automatically add a new keyframe whenever you move your puppet pin. Then, you do this. Hold click and select these. Press Ctrl C on your keyboard, and then Ctrl V. If you wanna do it again, do not press Ctrl V, or it will paste the whole layer. Select it again and copy paste. Select them all, right click on one of the keyframe. Keyframe assistant, easy ease. For the wiggly effect, select every keyframe on puppet pin 3, or the puppet pin on the bottom part of your hair. And then drag it to the right. You can check the movement by pressing space to play your preview. Turn down the resolution to half or third, or even quarter, for better experience. Unless if your PC can handle real-time preview in full resolution without became a freaking bomb. It tells you if your preview is moving in real-time or not, so don't worry. And do this to the rest of the hair. How to export, you say? File, export, add to render queue. If you can't press it, it means the last box you pressed is not the timeline or the preview box. Just press one of them, and there you go. Press this icon and change to H264. I don't know how to pronounce that. Click this yellow text if you wanna choose where you wanna save the video or change the file name. Click render. And there you have it. Hope it helped. And see you next time. Bye bye.